Thank you, everyone. I served as a commander in the military, and I am a survivor of sexual assault. And this is a very important issue to me. And as we say in the military, I'm going to give you the bottom line up front, our bluff. We wouldn't be where we are today without the tremendous leadership of my friends, Senator Gillibrand, Senator Grassley, and Senator Blumenthal. We've made some really, and I'll quote, momentous steps forward as retired Colonel Don Christensen, the former chief prosecutor of the United States Air Force and the president of Protect Our Defenders, said yesterday. From the prevention efforts, including education and greater security on our military bases, to the independent special trial counsel, we really have made some progress, taking steps forward that I do support. And that's because of the years of persistence of my colleagues. I am disappointed that we did not get every aspect of our bill included. And we should have the ability to do that. In part, this is due to the broken National Defense Authorization Act process we saw this year. We should have been on this bill much, much earlier so that we could have a robust debate about the extremely important issues, especially the one of sexual assault and military justice reform. The Senate Armed Services Committee passed our bill in the Senate NDAA in its entirety. We have the support of over 65 senators, a veto-proof majority. We should have a standalone vote on the Military Justice Improvement and Increasing Prevention Act. And I hope that at this point we can recognize that we have seen a number of momentous steps forward, very critical steps forward, and we have made this year's NDAA to prevent, we've made it so far in this year's NDAA so that we can help prevent sexual assault and hold accountable those who commit such atrocities against our service members. But we still have a long ways to go. So I am so grateful, Senators Gillibrand and especially Senators Grassley and Blumenthal as well, for their great leadership. Again, I want to stress that over and over, the commitment that they have had through the years and making sure we get this over the finish line is laudable and it's commendable. So we've made a lot of progress, probably some of the most important progress, most momentous progress that we have seen ever in our history of the Uniform Code of Military Justice. But we still have a number of steps to go, and we'll continue that fight. Thank you.